I would now like to invite Mr. Yerrigar Selvin to address the media.
Hi, good afternoon, one and all. We all stand here today to make one big vision come true, that's to help realize every sporting dream in our country. So before I start you, start taking you through the journey, I would like to say a few words.
Well, a very good afternoon to all of you. After that elaborate explaining, I don't think I need to say much, but from my side, I call him Mr. Y, you know, Yerrigar is too big a name to call. So we started having this interaction close to a year back or slightly more. And they are already in place at that point of time. And when they approached me and I was like, you know, I want you to work slightly more on it. And we put it on the public platform once I think we are completely ready. And I think this is the time when I can proudly say that we are ready. And we had to do a lot. That's why I said, you know, try to explain what this app really does, because at times, you know, it gets a bit confusing as to what is the purpose of the app. So thanks for the presentation, Mr. Y. And as we went across with what needs to be there, what needs to be part of it, and what else we can do, and that really took a lot of time. And when I felt that it was ready, you know, I had to convince him, you know, like, Yerrigar, I think I would like to get something in the company. And let's not play the valuation game. I'm the celebrity out here, so I'm not going to pay you what your valuation is. But definitely, I would like to get a part of the company. So finally, he agreed. There was a bit of negotiation. He agreed to it. And finally, I'm on board. But overall, I think it's a nice platform for everyone. It's not only for the top athletes, you know, it's not only about the Olympic athletes or, you know, only the state level athletes, even for recreational value, you know, people who just want to go out there, hire a venue to play some kind of a sport, you know, that's also there. And I feel not every athlete is destined to represent the country. But there are lots, you know, who will play for district, who will play for state. In cricketing terms, people will play Dilip Trophy. There will be people who will play 10 years, you know, when it comes to that kind of cricket. But still, there are a lot of help that they need at some point of time. And usually, it's the start of their career where they need that kind of a help. And that's where the concept of breaking what really athlete needs at that point of time, you know, that came in. And I said, you know, a lot of times when a person says, you know, I need this kind of a money to make sure that my next year is really happening and, you know, I'm at my best. And we said, why can't we break it down? You know, why can't we say, okay, my supplement needs are this much, my coaching needs are this much. And, you know, as basic as somebody who's playing state level says, I need a pair of spikes, I need a pair of bowling spikes. And it's not only for the big corporates or just the big institutions, you know, even somebody who is just a normal guy and decides to say, okay, I want to give a pair of spike to someone. And this is a platform where he can pick that kind of a guy. Okay, I want to give a youngster who's playing or representing the state who needs a bowling spike, and I would like to sponsor it. Because it's not about the quantity. It's not only about, okay, I want to pay that kind of money. It becomes a direct transaction between the individual and the athlete, and, you know, they can thank each other. And we actually don't take any commission or anything out of it. So it's covering a lot of angle. But, you know, to frankly say, I think it was a much needed platform. It gives a authenticity to the requirements of the athletes. And also, it integrates quite a few people together. Let's say, I was fortunate, you know, when I played in Ranchi, you know, I played for CCL for a long time and we had good practice facilities over there. But let's say if I needed a coach and, you know, I needed somebody who could help me out, it's very easy. There'll be athletes all over India who will be willing to give that kind of a guidance. They may not be the person who will be having their academies running, you know, throughout the year, but, you know, players who have represented the zonal cricketing activities or who have been ace cricket players for the state, you know, you can approach them over the app and you can say, okay, I would like to get 5 or 10 sessions off you. And, you know, maybe if you are interested, why can't you? It can be for free, it can be charged or anything. So it's a platform where all that can be done, and we are trying to make it as simple as possible. And that's where the verification concept came in, where we said, you know, we want to make sure that people or athletes who are part of the app are actually verify that leads, and you know they are the ones who are playing at all the different levels. So that's how it all started, and now we are here, you know, at the launch, and I'm really happy that it has happened. So that's from my side. You know, thanks a lot for being here, and you have written a book. You better sponsor a few spikes, huh? No, thanks, joking. Thanks.
I know it's MS Dhoni and you will have a lot of questions. So they are now open for questions, but request you to focus on the run Adam bit. Thank you. Before we take the questions, would you like to play a small video?
Athlete or a coach?
That was a very informative video indeed. They will now take any questions that you may have.
Okay. I know it's for that. I'll just tell you one thing. To win a test match, you need 20 wickets. And we did that. So that's the only answer I would give, because it doesn't matter how well you bat, how well you are there for 5 days, but if you're taking 20 wickets, you can win a test match.
Test one, number one ranking, Virat Kohli.
Well, he's the best, you know, and he's already reached a status when he's close to a legend state. So, you know, I'm very happy for him. And, you know, the way he has batted everywhere and the last few years he has just been brilliant, so he'll keep taking the team forward, and that's what you want from a leader. So, you know, all the best for him and very well done.
Hey, when you collected the match ball in the last ODI in England, a lot of fans were saying that it might be your last game. Any clarification to your fans?
Okay, is it the last question of cricket or more will come? No, you actually have to keep working. You know, what really is happening, and that was to see why we are not able to get enough reverse swing. Because we'll be playing the World Cup in England, what is it that we have to do so that we get reverse swing going? Because it's something that is very important. If the opposition is getting it, you know, we should also get it in some point or other. So that's why because now after 50 overs, you know, the ball is useless to the ICC. So I requested the umpire, can I get a ball? I gave it to the bowling coach and said, you know, we need to work on it, how we can get it more scuffed up, you know, so that we can get a bit of reverse swing going. That will in turn help the fast bowlers get those yorkers or wickets in the, you know, close to or after the 40th over mark. And that would really help us, you know, restrict the opposition by not getting too many runs in the last 10 overs. No, irrespective of whether I like it or not, I think she gets a lot of attention. And the thing is, wherever I go, people actually ask about her. So I'm nowhere in the scene right now. They see me like, okay, where is Ziva? Is she around? What is she doing? So, you know, it's good to have somebody like her around, which is who's a live wire. And once she gets up in the morning, you know, she's always on the move and she's very careful about what she does. So we are not worried that she may get hurt by doing something. So it feels good to have somebody around who can ease on the stress, you know, by not really pushing us to think anything. So it's good to have her, and it doesn't really matter whether I like or I don't like the attention that she's getting, because, you know, she's hardly 3 and a half and already, you know, she has a own character, and she talks in a particular way, and I think it's good to have a daughter, you know, who's always around.
Hi, Dhoni sir. A couple of things. First is, since we are promoting sports and Run Adam is one such platform, recently Mr. Rajyavardhan Singh Rathore, the union minister, has made a statement saying that by next year the syllabus will be reduced to half. so that, you know, this can promote sports, because sports is nothing but education. Any comment on that, sir?
Listen, frankly, I've not heard about it.
This is recently in the rugby.
Yesterday. I have no clue about yesterday. it, but it's not fair to make a comment on something that you have not heard. It will be interesting to see what the parents think about reducing the syllabus, you know, because not to forget, education is very important, but sport does teach you a lot about life. And school is, I feel, the right spot where, you know, you need to push the youngsters to play a lot of sport, and especially physical sport, outdoor sport. Indoor also qualifies, where badminton is there, squash is there, table tennis is there. But that's a time where they have that kind of a time where they can spend enough time on both. You know, nobody really knows. Like when I was in class 6th or 7th, I had no clue whether I'll become a cricketer, a footballer, athletics man, or I'll play badminton. So till I've not tried those sport at school level, how will I get to know what I'm good at?
Yeah.
And I feel, you know, in between there was a phase where parents were not too much interested into sport. They just wanted their children to study hard, get the best of result. And what is strange right now is, you know, 90% marks was considered like very good. And now the amount of students who get more than 90% is just enormous. You know, so for us, even if I was, you know, studying 24 hours a day, I can't think of reaching, you know, 90% marks at any point of time. But, you know, I was good in sport. I played a lot of sport. That's why that's something that really helped me be fit at my age right now. So I feel sport is a major part of life, and it teaches you a lot of things, you know, that will to win, the acceptance to losses, how to come back after having a bad loss. So, you know, mentally and physically, sports builds a lot of character, you know, when it comes to the students at an early age, and that actually helps you in your practical life a lot. So I just feel sports should be a big part of the student's life, and everybody should be pushed to play some kind of a sport, even if he doesn't want to.
So we are definitely giving platforms to new athletes who are willing to take their careers forward in this. But do you somewhere believe that after a person achieves one platform in life, or after they attain maybe something, they're not that much respected as they should be, because there has been a lot of controversies going on around. That's one. And second question, there is a lot of anticipation about your retirement too after you sign the ball. Any comment on that also?
I just answered that. But I was a bit confused about your first question as to what exactly is the first question.
So basically, we see athletes and sports people in sports returning back to India, not getting their honors. There are huge controversies in media as well, because they come forward and they say that, no, we are not getting as much respect as we want. So providing platform is one, but after they attain a particular stature for India, they attain that respect outside India as well. Do you think somewhere they are not respected that much that they should
I think
be?
It's for the common man of India, the common people of India to decide, you know, because at the end of the day, what is respect? Respect is something that comes out of the heart. You know, to me, somebody, you know, coming up to me and saying something is not respect. At the end of the day, I'm not somebody who looks for it. So I feel it's much more complex than that. And to grow a sporting culture, you need time. Sport is one thing, you know, often people confuse. Sports is not related to money. You know, you can't be like, okay, I am pumping in 500 crores. Next Olympic, how much medal are we getting? You don't get it like that. You know, you have to build an infrastructure. You have to provide the right kind of guidance to the individuals who are playing the sport, and then wait for it. It's a long-term investment. It's not a short-term investment where you build something, you give it, and you know you're expecting results in the next 3 to 4 years. So I feel we need to develop our sporting infrastructure in a way where the infrastructures are used in a proper way. You know, one of the good things is wherever national games happens, you know, a lot of infrastructure is built for all the sport at that place. But what is important, what are we doing with it, you know, once the national game has happened? How well we are using the infrastructure? How well it is getting provided to the individuals who really need it? But at the same point of time, it can't be an open ground for everyone. You can't have, you know, kids going in and playing over there. At some kind of restriction is needed, but how well we are using the infrastructure and once you guide it, once you have a proper channel as to, you know, what really needs to done to be done, you know, to succeed in that kind of a sport, then you have to wait and watch. Because it can't be like, you know, let's say I have the infrastructure and everything, I start playing badminton today and tomorrow I'll get a medal. You know, it's the coming generations that keep working hard. They look up to individuals who start doing well, and that really, you know, attracts them to the sport. The more the number of people play the sport, the higher the chances of success are. You know, and that's what really happens in cricket also. You know, it's a sport that gets played all over India, almost all over India, and the amount of people, you know, only 15 people play for the country. But the amount of people, the feeding ground is, the feeding system is so big that even if a few who are very good or who may not play and would have left cricket, still we get a lot of very good cricketers. So I feel that needs to be done to every sport, and it will happen over a period of time. We can't just, you know, force it and say, okay, I'm pumping in 1,000 crores, I need 5 Olympic medals. You know, it doesn't happen that way.
Dhoni sir, my question is to you. So recently India won the World Cup, India won the soccer match against Argentina. So what, you've been always supportive of football. So what you have to say about this?
Well, if you see, you know, ISL started a few years back, and, you know, it gave the Indian players a chance to rub shoulders against some of the players of the world, you know, who are very successful in the sport. And yes, you know, some of them were not at their peak, you know, when they came to India, but it gives them a benchmark as to where they need to be. If these guys are so fit at this point of time and entire 90 minutes, how they play, how they prepare, you know, it gave them a new challenge. It pushed them to set their benchmarks slightly high. And right over the years, you know, the first edition of IPL was, ISL was different. The second year, we saw, you know, the games getting improving slowly. And that's what I meant, you know. All these platforms, you know, all these leagues that are happening, that are raising the standard of sport in our country. And slowly, we'll start getting the desired result. You know, it's not only the people or the sports person who are playing ISL. You know, it encourages the 16-year-old, the 17-year-old, the 18-year-old, not only to follow football, but to go and play football. You know, you can actually follow football. A lot of people or youngsters I've met, they know the inside out of football, and when you ask them, okay, when do you play? Like, no, FIFA. So they're actually getting more knowledge out of playing FIFA on PlayStation 4. You know, but you want them to go and actually play. So, like, Astro football is very popular right now. You know, all over Mumbai, if you see, there's so many places where you can hire it for like an hour, you can go and play. And a lot of people are doing it. So that's how sports gets, you know, popular over the period of time.
So now it's, don't you think that it's a boost for Indian players to, because they've already won, so even the government should support our team?
Listen, government is working at its own level. You know, it's, again, you know, to blame everything on the government, you know, are you married? Do you have a son or a daughter? Are you pushing them to play a sport? You know, those are the things we need to care about, what is in my control. You know, we always find an excuse, ye nahi hua, wo nahi hua, wo nahi hua. And when you're looking for excuses, you don't look at the strengths. So I feel if we start sending our sons and daughters to play sport, you know, the more the number of people play, you know, better it is for us. And it's for good, it's good for everyone. So let's not look for excuses, ye hona chahiye, wo hona chahiye, because I've heard it a lot of times. The best is when the question comes back, aapko kya lagta hai, kya karna chahiye? Toh aadmi bolta hai, nahi, wo sab nahi pata, galti unki hai. You know, we have to be constructive. You know, we all have restrictions. You know, we are a big population. You know, we have to worry about a lot of things. It's not only sport. Sport is definitely a big part of it, but there are a lot of things we need to worry about. But we all can contribute to it. And all those small contributions are the one that really matters. You know, let's not look for the big contribution. Chodi chodi cheez jo hum kar sakte hain, jo aap kar sakte hain, wo hum karte hain, we'll get the desired result over the period of time.
Thank you, sir.
So you just mentioned that about like how sports should be encouraged like in school from a very young age, like, and that's how you like children will learn sports, and that's how sports will grow. So do you have any ideas of how sports can be incorporated into like the education system? Like, since we just heard that the union minister also encourage sports to be encouraged into the education system. So for example, like I play chess. So for example, like for me personally, chess has taught me like about like business skills, like analytical skills. So do you have any other ideas of how sports can be incorporated into education?
Again, it is a very complex process because it needs to be incorporated into the syllabus. But at the same point, you can't have a situation where, you know, your entire marking depends on what you're earning out of sport also. So as I said, it's slightly more complex, but what is important to have designated times every day for sport, you know, and I want most of it to be a sport that involves a lot of physical activity. And, you know, if let's say if I am not an athlete, if I'm not a professional cricketer or a badminton player, but if I've played enough sport in school, it becomes like a culture, you know, and it helps you stay fit in life. So if you have sport every day as part of your life, even after you get a employment with any institution, you will make sure you take some time out of it, you know, so that you're going to, let's say, badminton court or a tennis court to go and play some kind of sport. So even if nothing, it helps you be fit. But as I said, if you're playing, let's say, till fourth, everybody plays sport. Let's say from class six onwards to 12th also, if you're participating in sport, that's the chunk of time where you learn a lot about life. And as I said, when you are in sport, you're competing against someone, you will win some, you will lose some. It will teach you about the mistakes that you have committed. You know, it will teach you how to get out of it, how you can't get demoralized out of it. And also in life, that's what it's all about. You know, you can't get bogged down by the losses that you have had. You know, you always have to look up, you know, you have to take things in your stride, and you have to accept the mistakes that you have made. You know, a lot of times we don't accept the shortcomings that we have. You know, no, yeah, theek hai, wo theek hai. But you need strength to accept that, okay, there's some shortcoming in me or my game, because that's how you improve yourself. So that's why I feel, you know, sports should be a major part of it. How to incorporate it is slightly more complex, but, you know, sports has been part of the school curriculum. It's just that we need to give slightly more emphasis on that. Last two questions, huh?
Hi, so I just want to know about this app. Like,
thank you, which, finally.
So this app, the video has shown like Olympic athletic, just we got two medals for India. So do you think this app is going to get something, like we are going to get more medals, or this going to change future of India sports?
If this guaranteed medals, you know, I would have made 15 more apps like this, which means 30 more medals. But, you know, again, as I said, it's not about that. You know, we want to incorporate a lot of things into one platform. And that's where the verification process is there. We need to get used to the needs of an athlete. What is needed at that point? As I said, you know, not everybody is blessed. You know, once you're playing a sport initially, what we are talking about is underage group. You know, it may be under 16, under 19. That's the real time when you need a lot of guidance. You need a lot of support. And it's only one dimension of this app. You know, it involves coaching. Yerega has talked about how we are placing coaches. We are talking to a lot of institutions about the CSR that they actually want to spend, but they don't know how actually to spend it. So this will be a place where they can pick the individuals. You know, we can incorporate, let's say, a sports brand and a CSR guy, and they take care of the utility of the athlete. It may be the clothing, it may be the shoes or whatever the requirement is, and they can do it directly, you know, no money comes to us. So we're just giving them a platform. We're making sure that the athletes are verified at least. So in turn, when the clothing is going to the athlete, it is going to the right person. The athlete in turn thanks both of them, and nothing comes to us. So it's a platform where it gives the institutions and the sporting brand and the athletes a platform where, you know, whatever is needed, it can be given to them. And, you know, it can be done to take care of the needs of the athlete and to help them move forward, because a lot of them will go on to represent their state for a considerable amount of time. And I always say it's not only about the Olympics medal or the World Cups, you know, it's about the athletes who don't reach or represent India, but they still have their own requirements, and those are the ones who don't get that kind of a support. You know, when you're playing for India, you get almost everything. You know, all the major sports, yes, there are a few sports where it may not happen, But you know, usually you get, you know, you won't be bothered about a pair of shoes or the clothing because you will get it. But it's the requirement that is below that. When you're playing for your state, you know, when you're representing your zone and when you're below India, you know, that's the kind of level where it's really needed. And if you can do that, a lot of them may not quit the sport at that point of time because they got the required support.
So Mahi, I have two questions over here. So Ranadam is a very technology-oriented platform. Being said that, number one is how technology-oriented are you? And number two is India, in a lot of sports people that come out of India are not from a very well-off background sometimes. And how do you think Ranadam will cater to those people? And how do you think that we'll reach across to all these different kind of people?
So I'll pass on the second message, second question to him so that he also answers sitting here. But me and technology, you know, there's a big divide. Yes, I do use technology, but I'm not really too much of a phone person. And I think there's so many stories that I don't need to speak of even one of them. But at the same time, there are a lot of technological things that I do use. And, you know, it actually helps in your sport also. If you have a video analyst, he can slow down the video. He can get thousands of videos. And actually, a lot of times when he gives you the video, at times you think, do I really play cricket? Because he'll show you the uncomfortable deliveries and you'll be like, you know, I'm not even middled one, you know, everything is going around. And then you realize, like, you take everything in a positive way. You're like, I must be doing something right. I'm at least not edging it to the keeper. So, you know, that's how it is. You know, technology can really help you do better, but you need to use it in the right way, whether it's sport or whether it's in business or all the other aspects. And how we are moving forward, you know, it's becoming more and more about technology. You know, we do a lot of ad film shoots. I realized the time I started, we used to have this cassette. You have to insert the cassette and just record. Now it's all HD and memory disk and all of that. So, you know, it has changed a lot, you know, when it comes to technology. You still remember the first question or you want him to?
Yeah,
I tend to forget all this.
Okay, so my second question was...
first question.
So
okay.
Second I answered. You know, the first I answered.
Yeah,
second.
Yeah.
So I think the reach of technology is gone. Everybody's got a mobile phone right now, and you would be surprised by the people number of Swiggy users and other users. I think technology is not there. I don't think so. I believe there, but yeah, still the problem that we face will be language problem. Could be the app might not, the English will be not working. So we are working on to create custom language apps. So that's the only barrier that we see to crack.
And also the amount of cell phones, smartphones that we are selling, the amount of Twitter, Instagram, Facebook users that we have, I think all of them, you know, they know how to use a mobile phone. And that's what is really needed. You don't really have to be very technology oriented when it comes to this app. And the best is you'll see your guard, you know, her apartment ke niche ek guard rehta and how they're watching. So they have a power bank also. They insert a SD card, they watch movies. And next day, they actually interchange it with the guard on the next apartment. So, you know, technology, we are quite used to technology now. But thanks, I am really tired of this, but thanks for coming.
Okay, last question.
Okay.
So amazing to see you backing up. Okay.
Listen, they scold you also, it's not only me.
Okay, so it's amazing to see you backing up such an initiative. And what motivated you to take a 25% stake in Ranadam?
You know, as I said, over the period we were working on it, and there was a point where I wanted it to operate in a certain way and take care of all the aspects of, you know, what it was providing. And we are having this on and off interaction because I was also playing a bit of cricket. So, you know, once I saw the complete product and I saw the potential, I was like, you know, I've really put in a lot of effort in this, and I think it has a good future. And I can do good. You know, it's not only about making money when it comes to the app, but we can integrate a lot of different things, and it can be beneficial for not only the athletes, but also a lot of corporates and institutions, you know, who are looking to move when it comes to sport, you know, who want to push sport forward. And it's not only about the big names, even the small names, even people who have represented their state, you know, they can add on as being a coach. And this is a platform that provides that. And not everybody wants to open up an academy. There are a few who will be like, you know, I want to only work 2 days in a week when it comes to sport because I have a job that requires me to give a lot. So this platform can address all of that. Yes, you only want to operate on a Sunday? You can. You know, you only want to operate 6 to 8 on a particular day? You can. So it has that versatility of, you know, operating whenever you want. And you can, the athletes have a choice, the coaches also have a choice. You know, where they want to operate, who they want to pick, who they don't want to pick. So that was the reason I said it looks to have a good future, and I've put in so much of a effort from my side. Yes, now to get it into reality was his job, you know, where he's the technology guy, he gets everything incorporated into the app. So that was the difficult part, which was his. So that was the reason I said I would definitely like to be a part of it, and that's why, you know, I'm here today. Awesome. Thanks.
Please, 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 please.
Thank you.